So we had the pleasure of meeting at Telluride.
Yes, sir.
Which is where your journey officially began with this film.
Yes, sir.
I'm curious, now that it's been to multiple festivals and you've kind of toured a little bit of the world with this movie,
yeah.
How does it feel as a filmmaker to have this kind of reception of your film?
It feels amazing, and like genuinely, some of these screenings we've had, like the energy and like seeing how the movie affects and connects, and when it connects, it really connects with some people, and seeing that's been one of the most beautiful, humbling feelings in the world. So I'm always, it's a lot, we're traveling a lot, working a lot, but it's like getting to, I don't know, every new screen you're like, oh, I don't know, are they going to connect like that? Is that going to happen? And when it does, it's so beautiful, man.
Yeah. Is there one in particular that you had, and I know this is asking a lot of you because I know everyone is different.
Of course.
Is there one that has stood out?
I think for all of us, it was probably a DC screening we had. It was kind of mind blowing. We were, Obama's spiritual advisor was moderating with us, and the energy was unbelievable. So many things happened. There was a young man who had lost his best friend not long ago, and lost other friends to violence in his neighborhood, and he just said he connected so deeply with it, and it made him want to sort of like break down barriers with his dad and open up in new ways and try to get through his grief. And it was mind-boggling, man. And then he brought his dad to a screening the next day. We did it at his school. We met that same night too. This young woman was like there with her mom, and she was like, "We're gonna have a big talk after this." Like it, because that, and that's what I saw too. Like sometimes the movie will connect, especially between parents and children, and the different point of views and perspectives, and the idea of like each of them seeing it and connecting, and then that helping some communication and some aspect of what's going on with them. That, I mean, that's unbelievable. There was another girl that was crying to me after, and we were hugging. She made me cry, and she was just talking about the way it connected her with her sister and family. So it was one of the best moments of my life. It was truly unbelievable.
That's amazing. I've told you when I saw it at Telluride, and I've seen this movie again, and I love the cast. I love everything about this movie. This is a phenomenal film. The thing that I've been dying to ask you is about the aspect ratio.
Yeah.
Thought process behind that, and it makes it a must-see on the big screen.
I hope so. That was the goal, because I think ratio is another huge tool we have at our disposal. And for this one, it was all about basically working with the film grammar in general on the film of embracing this subjective, immersive filmmaking. So the ratio starts in like 1.85 full frame, wide lenses, feeling the full push and pull of Tyler's world. And then as Ty's world starts collapsing in, the ratio is essentially collapsing in with him. We go to 2.40 after he gets the news. Well, I can't spoil a movie. After
yeah.
certain things,
yes.
When substances are involved, we go to anamorphic lenses and a native anamorphic 2.66, which has a shallower depth of field and different flares, and it's more expressionistic. So long story short, we're like really trying to put you in his head and close in. And then as things happen in our story and another character takes over, I think that journey is a lot about learning to, trying to love yourself again and heal. And as she's going on that journey, we're opening back up again, you know? So we end in the midway point of our story in 1.33, just like perfect ratio for faces. And then it's sort of about growing back out and getting back, opening up to the world, if that makes sense. So then we end finally in 1.85 that we started the movie.
Yeah.
So that's a big broad way of talking about
okay.
it.
Okay. I have to set up another interview.
Okay, sorry.
No, dude, I have a lot of things and I love to
Let's do it. Let's
so
do another.
I'm going to get you on like one of the shows and we can do a podcast
good.
Together or something.
I can't wait. It's going to be great. Okay, brother. Okay.